In this tutorial, we're going to create an alias with a nice icon that's going to boot the terminal alongside Blender so you can see the output of Python and see any errors in your Blender scripts or add-ons. All right, we'll start off with opening Blender and going to the scripting workspace. Head on over to the Python Interactive Console and type in bpy.app.binarypath. This will give you the path to the Blender executable. Go ahead and copy that and let's open it in Finder. So use go to folder and paste in that path. This is the path, this is the executable that we're going to be using. If you click on it and launch it, you'll see it launch in a terminal right away. Basically, we're almost done. We just need to make an alias from this. So let's just do that. Let's move that executable into the desktop. And let's just launch this to make sure that it works. Looks like it's working. Now it's time to just test and see if we can see the output and errors if we ever get any. So let's create a new file and print out something like monkey. All right, let's launch that. As you can see, print out monkey. Awesome, let's now print 100 monkeys on each line. Let's run that again. And as you can see, there's more than one monkey here. All right, let's create an error and see what happens. So we're gonna delete a parentheses, and as you can see, Blender is telling us, hey, there's an error. But when this disappears, we can still find where the error happens in the terminal, right? So it's showing us on line one that you're missing something here. All right, now we need to add our final touch and update the icon so it doesn't look so boring. We're gonna need preview for this. So let's first get the info for this and get the icon. Just copy that. And then we need to open preview. Let's open it. Let's actually open the resources and get the icons. And that's preview right there. We need to create a new file from whatever is in the clipboard. So yeah, let's just do that. Just copy the Blender logo and then paste that in on top of this. Just looks nice. Let's copy this and update that alias. All right, now we can distinguish this alias from the other alias, right? So let's double check and launch it, make sure it works. All right, looks like it's working. Awesome. Make sure to also check out the Blender documentation so you can see another way that you can launch the terminal alongside Blender. For more videos like this, make sure to subscribe. Thanks for watching.